Hey, hello everyone and welcome you all on the Learn, Know and Grow the World best loving platform. As you already know that here you get latest tech updates and tech news. So today the first update is, and before going to entering this video, you can subscribe, share, like this channel, okay? In this video I'm going to giving some updates. So first update is Paragon is working to get its NTFS3 file system into the Linux kernel. In March of last year, proprietary file system vendor Paragon Software unleashed a stream of anti-open source FUD about a Samsung-derived X-Fact implementation headed into the Linux kernel. Several months later, Paragon seemed to have seen the error of its ways and began the arduous process of getting its own implementation of Microsoft NTFS, the default file system for all Windows machines, into the kernel as well. Although Paragon is still clearly struggling to get its process and practices aligned to open source friendly ones. Okay. Linux kernel BDFL Linus Torvalds seems to have taken a personal interest in the process. After nearly a year of effort by Paragon, Torvalds continues to gently nudge both it and skeptical Linus devs in order to keep the project moving forward. Okay, if you want to know more each and every detail, you can visit on my link in description box. The next update is, as you also know that I want to cover more and more to more updates in this video, okay? And I don't want to make this video very large and boring, so I am giving the main points related update. But request to you that go and visit and read and take and learn, know and grow, okay, from here. Okay, the next update is Xiaomi takes the smartphone sales crown and Samsung seems unhappy about it. So let's listen about this. Hot off its climb to the number 2 spot for Q2 2021, Xiaomi is the world's biggest smartphone vendor for the first time. That's according to July's number from Counterpoint Research, which was Xiaomi in first with 17.1% of the global market, Samsung in second with 15.7% and Apple in third with 14.3%. Okay. Counterpoint says Xiaomi market share grew 26% month over month. Okay. Huawei has been plummeting in the market share charts as the effects of the multi-year US export ban caught up with the company. The next point is Xiaomi covers every possible market segment with 58 smartphone models currently listed on its global website. Okay, the next point is, as for Samsung, which Xiaomi blew by the become number one, Counterpoint says the company is facing temporary problems due to of COVID-19 in Vietnam. So next point related to this, the report says that Samsung is highly likely to miss its sales target for Galaxy S21, which so far has sold 13.5 million units during the first half of the year. If you want to know more in each and every info, you can visit my link, okay? The next update is, yes, so next update is related, third update is Spotify calls off plans to support AirPlay to frustrating iPhone users. Okay, this was update, and regarding main points regarding this update I am going to give you. iPhone users have been asking for Spotify to add AirPlay 2 support for ages, but yesterday Spotify told users they should not expect the feature to be added anytime soon. Okay, AirPlay 2 was added to iOS more than 3 years ago and users have been asking for Spotify to support it for many months. Okay, if you have been following both Apple and Spotify over the past few years, you might not find this news surprising. In the past, it would not have been possible for Spotify to support many of the iPhone's platform specific features as they were researched. Okay. So next update is, regarding this update you can visit in link in description box. Okay. Fourth update is Stringle is a privacy focused open source photo backup application. With Google Photos killing off its unlimited photo backup policy last November, the market for photo backup and sync application opened up considerably. Okay. We reviewed one strong contender, Amazon Photos, in January, and freelancer Alex. Okay. Today we are looking at a new contender, Stringle Photos, which splits the difference offering a FOSS mobile application that syncs to a managed clouds. Trust no one. Okay. So if you want to know more, you can visit in link in description box. But I am sharing with some points. Since the photos are encrypted before ever leaving your phone using a key that is not ever available to single operators, you are safe from attackers getting a photo dump from single cloud. Okay, regarding transparency, Stringle has gone out of its way to make how it works as clear as possible to security and privacy focused users. The next one is having access to the source code especially helps close potential loopholes in what a Stringle can and cannot do with your photos. We didn't attempt anything like a full code audit of the Stringle Photos app. Okay. So next point is key backup. By default, Stringle Photos uploads a backup of the user's private key to the single cloud, which is hosted at DigitalOcean using redundant Wasabi buckets. This allows the app to function on a new device without the user having a manually and cumbersomely backup and restore the private key themselves. Okay, so each and every you can visit on my link. Okay, this is very big update and I cannot share in this speaking format, so you should read and know more. Yes, so next update, you should listen very carefully about this new glow worm attack. Recovers audio from devices power LEDs. Researchers at Ben Gurion University of the Negev have demonstrated a novel way to spy on electronic conversations. A new paper released today outlines a novel passive of the Tempset attack called Glowworm, which converts minutes fluctuations in the intensity of power LEDs on speakers and USB hubs back into the audio signals that cause those functions. Okay, so you should know about this update also. You can visit there. So the next update is Google illegally considered buying Epic Games to silence antitrust complaints. So in this video, I'm going to tell you that Google and Epic Games kicked off a years-old spat over Fortnite on the Play Store. Instead of distributing the game through Google Play, Epic decided that sideloading would be the way to get Fortnite on Android, thereby sidestepping Google's 30% cut of sales. Epic would go on to file an antitrust complaint against Google, and newly unleashed court documents reported by The Verge reveal an interesting solution that Google was kicking around at the time the company was considering buying Epic. Okay, this was the update main points. Okay, and you can visit to more each and every info related this update. And the next update is today's Firefox 91 release adds new site wide cookie clearing action. Okay, Mozilla Firefox 91 release this morning includes a new privacy management feature called enhanced cookie clearing. The feature allows users to manage all cookies and locally store data generated by a website, regardless of whether they are cookies tagged to that site's domain or cookies placed from that site but belonging to a third-party domain, example Facebook or Google. Building on total cookie protection, you can visit on my website to know more. Okay, and on this section you will know about clearing data site-wide. You will know related Fugeda Bodit. Okay, get strict. This kind of information you are getting regarding this update. Okay, you can visit. You should visit. So thanks for coming here. And today, these were the updates. Next coming updates I will give you next time. Okay. So how was this update? If you like, share, subscribe this channel. Okay. Thanks for coming here.